ChatGPT is probably one of the most powerful AI out there, and I wanted to check if it can teach me Final Cut Pro. Let's get it. I'm using the desktop version because it's a free version, and if you want to get here, just go to openai.com and then go to learn more about ChatGPT. You'll have to create a login account, but it's no big deal. So what we're going to do is literally just type, teach me how to use Final Cut Pro. And if you guys are even more curious, maybe write, teach me everything you know about Final Cut Pro. But today we're going to go with teach me how to use Final Cut Pro. And then we're going to click on send message and let's see what kind of answer it will generate. Okay, pause. Right off the bat, it started with import your media, which is not bad, but I don't think it's the first thing I wish I would have known first. You know, knowing more about Final Cut Pro's file management and storage management, I would have loved to learn about that first, because when I switched from Premiere Pro to Final Cut Pro, the number one thing that bothered me was seeing this message. And I know I have a video on this, but I'm gonna give you the quick version of how to deal with that today. So go to Preferences under Final Cut Pro up here, and then go to Import. And based on what you want or the volume of your storage, choose copy to library or leave files in place. I personally prefer leaving them in the same place and make a copy in another external hard drive as a backup. You know, with most machines nowadays, I don't think you need transcoding at all at import. Most media format are supported and we don't need Final Cut Pro to create unnecessary copies, mostly for playback purposes. So uncheck all of them, then go to playback. Same thing here, uncheck background rendering because it also creates copies just for a smoother playback. You know what, I'm gonna link that video up here, go check it out. It should help you with your storage management workflow. But let's go back to ChatGPT's answer. So after import, it goes to organize your project, your media. I will do the same thing after importing. Create timeline, of course, you have to do that if you are editing. And then edit. So basic editing tips here, fine-tune transitions and titles, keyframes. Okay, and then export. That's pretty good. Basic, but pretty good. But what if we just ask it in the same chat, of course, what should I do before importing? Just to see if it's gonna talk about storage management. So what do we have here? Okay, organize your files. That's good, but not about storage. Plan your project. Or the structure, so think ahead and visualize what you want to do to your video. Always helpful to do that. Transcoding, there you go. And I like that they put if necessary, because it should always be a choice. And notice it doesn't talk specifically about storage management, but it's still pretty good for, you know, a response from an AI. Okay, now it's time to rate this AI experience, guys. And I would probably give it a rating to about 7 out of 10. And of course, you have to factor in the way you are asking your questions and how detailed do you want it to be. But what do you guys think? How would you rate the way ChatGPT answered this question from 1 to 10? How would you rate it from 1 to 10? Let me know in the comment section. That's it. If you guys get any value from this one, subscribe and check out these other videos for Final Cut Pro users. I will see you guys in the next one, hopefully. Peace.